Abhijit says, can we design one indoor, one outdoor unit for hot gas defrost? Can we use hot gas defrost for small units? Yes and no. The slide that I've got up on the system now basically shows an incredibly simple hot gas setup. Now, this system has some challenges. We've got our, you know, compressor discharge through the condenser, you know, liquid line, solenoid valve, expansion valve, evaporator. Then we've got a crankcase pressure regulating valve, or it might be a evaporator pressure regulating valve, and that's the sort of normal operation. If you want to do something very, very simple, you can take a tapping off the discharge line through a hot gas mag valve or solenoid valve that basically feeds hot gas into your expansion line just after the expansion device. Should really have a check valve. And then it will go through the evaporator, heating the evaporator up and melting, you know, ice, frost, etc. Challenge is that's a one-to-one system. So we get a sort of ever reducing amount of hot gas because we're putting hot gas into the evaporator here. It's condensing back to a liquid. We're not really going to put a lot of vapor back to the compressor. So in essence, the system runs out of hot gas. It's okay for a very quick, short burst of hot gas to the evaporator. But you will eventually run out of hot gas because you're not getting any vapor back to the compressor to compress, et cetera, et cetera. The other bigger issue is the risk of liquid slug back to the machine. Now, you can see here we've got a nice big suction accumulator or slop pot, as I've called them in the past. And that hopefully protects our machine against liquid because a compressor is a vapor pump. It's not a liquid pump. It can be mitigated by the use of what's called a re-evaporator coil. So sometimes you have one evaporator and then you might have what they call this re-evaporator coil to you know, boil off the rest of that liquid, and then we get some vapor back to the compressor. So yes, if you ask me, would I install it, then not really, because it would run out of hot gas. Really, for a proper hot gas system, you need at least, in a medium temperature system, you need at least two evaporators running and one on defrost. And then if it's a low temperature application, you need at least three evaporators running and one evaporator on a defrost to actually generate the amount of hot gas required to melt that evaporator.